What?
Huh? Oh no, just something unrelated. Okay, are you ready to go
Can't
to...
just be laughing like that and then not tell me what the joke is.
You'll find out, you'll find out.
What do you mean I'll find out?
So welcome everybody. Today we're doing our Lord Huron tier list. So we have our tiers here, boom. We have our songs here, boom, and we are ready. Elliot, how do you feel?
I'm ready. I know we're going to agree.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. I hope we're going to agree. I hope we're going to agree.
We're going to agree.
What tier do you think is going to have the most songs in?
When the moment's good.
I think so. I think here's the thing I want to say. All of these tiers, like there's definitely the top four, are still very good songs, you know. Like if this was compared to just like load of bands and it was just some Lord Huron's songs
You
running there.
imagine his tears, bud.
Pardon? Pardon?
You want to change those tears?
Which one?
The bottom one.
Huh? What do you mean? What
You know what I
do
mean? Get that out of here right now.
you want to change it
Don't know. Whatever. Just not
to?
up.
Hold
Something
for
that
a
makes
sec.
sense.
Pardon?
Something that makes sense.
Oh, what about Wouldn't Miss It?
Okay.
That's a spicy one. Like, it's not so bad, but like if you never like if it was deleted, you wouldn't miss it. That's an interesting choice.
Okay.
I was thinking as well, because this is like a very different kind of tier list, maybe we could play like a little snippet, maybe. That'd be quite interesting, I think. I think before we start, I think my prediction is that we'll agree most on Viet Noir, the Viet Noir songs.
I think we'll agree most on Strange Trials.
I was tempted, but I didn't know how much you liked it, though.
Well, I guess you'll find out.
I think we'll agree most on you being wrong.
Okay.
For anyone who doesn't know, I actually have a tattoo of Lord Huron. So this is why I'm
Hey.
very nervous. Huh?
What?
What did you say?
I thought you were going to say I have a tattoo, so clearly I'm the bigger fan.
Oh no, I wasn't saying it's like one up you, I was just to let him know for contact that like this is like a big band for both of us.
Oh, okay.
Like this isn't just like picking out a Coldplay song, you know.
Let's do it.
Okay, so I've actually gone through the effort of putting the songs in order.
Okay.
So the first song that we have, which is also the first song from Lost in Dreams, is Ends of the Earth.
I need to play these, man. Can
I've got it ready to play if you want.
I hear it? Oh, damn. Okay.
Dude, we're ready already. So, do you want me to like actually hear it or do you want me to just skip like to the chorus?
I know Ends of the Earth. And I'd say when the moment's good.
I would say, you know what? Yeah, I'll back that. It's a very good song. It's a very good song. I like some of the lyrics as well. Some very good lyrics.
Yeah.
Like, oh, what's the one? I guess you know this because you listen to it, but like he says a lot of stuff that is impossible and then he's going to do it, you know?
Yeah.
I can't, like, he says, like, obviously, Ends of the Earth is the obvious one, but he's like, there's a river that goes on forever and he's going to see where it goes and stuff. And I just like the imagination of it, you know?
Yeah.
So,
I will
yeah.
say,
Yeah.
I think I have a bias for it, for Lonesome Dreams, mainly because that was the album that my first Lord Huron song was from.
Which one?
Ends of the Earth was my first Lord Huron song.
It was one of my first as well. It was one of my first.
And also the fact that I like the overall story.
Okay.
I get into it a lot more than the other ones because obviously in Strange Trails, it's jumping around.
Yeah. No, okay,
And
that's
then
true.
in Viet Noir, I get the story, but I don't know. It's still a bit open to interpretation.
Yeah. I'm already getting it. What do you mean? I think End of Year, we can both agree that being there. That's a reasonable choice.
Okay.
But it is deep down, like, one of my favorites. I'm going to say that about half of these. But it is, like, it's a classic, isn't it?
Yeah.
Like, when you think of Lord Hurd, you think of this song, it's, like, eventually.
Mm-hmm.
Next, we have Time to Run.
I wouldn't skip it.
Pardon?
I wouldn't pick it, but I wouldn't skip it.
I'm with you. I'm with you 100%. I wouldn't pick it because of the intro.
Mm-hmm.
It's got a beefy intro, but once you get into it, it does get you excited.
I feel like that's half the songs.
No, that's the one thing I will say. And I'm not going to, like, because there's some songs that have an intro, which I really like. So I'm not going to say I'm everyone.
Yeah.
But I will say, like, when you start listening to Lord Hurd, if you're going through just skipping songs, see which one you think sound good. You skip a lot of good ones because you hear the intro and you're like, eh.
Yeah.
Once you listen past the intro, you do get hyped for it.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I think. A lot of my songs that I really like now, which I'll explain in a minute, is
ones with weird intros.
Yeah, but because like I'll be in the car, or I'll be like on a plane or whatever, and I'll just listen to all the songs like without picking any. I mean, afterwards, I'll be like, oh, what was that one song that had, like, that one bit that I didn't recognize?
Yeah.
And I'll find it, I'll be like, oh, damn, that was I didn't realize that was a good song.
No, yeah.
I'm like, damn, I've been skipping this one.
I'll tell you, but there's one on air. I'll remember it when I hear it. But okay. It was when I was around yours, and we were talking about, like, theremin and stuff, and, like,
yeah.
And then they were playing one song, and I was like, what song is this?
Oh, damn, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that happens so much. And then afterwards, like, later on, you'll be, like minding your business. You think about it, but that's kind of a good song, you know?
Yeah, it's like, good. I need to find this.
Yeah. Oh, dude, that happens so much. Okay, so far doing good. Now we've got Lonesome Dreams.
Lonesome Dreams, Grammy the Oaks.
I would put it repeat till I'm sick of it. No, I don't know. I wouldn't maybe even put it when the moment's good.
No, you know what? I have one song that I think I'd say Grab Me the Orcs.
Yeah?
Put Lonesome Dreams in repeat till I'm sick of it.
But wait, what are we casting as Grab Me the Orcs?
Like, bangers. Like, you would blast this, like, on the radio in your car.
Okay. But it's not actually technically Grab Me the Orcs?
No.
Because there are the problem with Lord Hurd is like if someone asked me like, oh, put a song on, I wouldn't necessarily put it on because I'm like, well, I don't want to ruin the vibe, you know.
No.
You don't want to go from like Ed Sheeran to this. So that's what I just wanted to clarify. Mm.
Okay.
But damn, did you say there's only one that you can think of?
Maybe.
Oh man. Okay. Actually, there's one that is a guarantee for me.
Mm-hmm.
Which I hope you're gonna say the same.
Okay.
We got Ghost on the Shore.
When the moment's good.
That you say when the moment's good?
I say when the moment's good.
Okay.
What would you say?
I would say maybe I wouldn't pick it, but I wouldn't skip it.
Really?
I don't think I've actually ever picked it. But I've never intentionally put it on.
Okay.
But what would you say, though? Because you quite like it, don't you?
I'd say when the moment's good.
I don't know, but I'd...
Like if you just listen to the lyrics, man, I know you'd pick it. Come on, don't tell me you ain't picturing Lord Hurd when you listen to the song.
You know what? I'll give it to you.
Okay.
But thank I will say I feel like this is gonna be tough, you know. It's gonna be tough. I really hate this. Because the thing is, I'm now looking at this like, damn, I do like Time to Run. The funny thing is though, is like I feel like I'm like arguing about like my children.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, because just then I was like, oh, do I give it to him? I'm like, what am I doing? It's a Little Drummer Song. Let's bump it up. Okay, this one for me, She Lit a Fire.
I wouldn't pick it up. I wouldn't skip it.
I would say I hate it for now.
Really?
Maybe. Pardon?
Keep going.
I'll keep going.
You know.
Pardon?
What's wrong with it? When he kind of speeds up.
Oh, you want me to go to when he speeds up?
No, no, that was it. Like, at the end of the line, like, she left no trace, but I know her. Like, just love that.
Okay. Oh, dude, you get me. Yeah, you know what? Yeah, let's do it. Wait, you want to say here?
I'd say there.
Yeah, okay, definitely not any higher, but I think I can back that. I can back that. Because, like, oh, man, a lot of these I feel like I'm going to be like, okay, I'll put it here. When I hear it, I'm like, it's decent.
Yeah.
Okay, the next one. I Will Be Back One Day.
Play it. I really like this song.
Pardon?
I really like this song. I say when the moment's good.
I would say I hate it for now.
Really?
Well, hang on. Should we maybe change this? Because I hate the hate it for now bit.
No, but that was like a reference to when like I hated every song. But then
I get it. No. I know what you mean, but I just feel like it gives the wrong impression.
Okay, sure.
Because sometimes I would skip this, you know.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Go on. You know you sometimes you skip that one.
I really wouldn't. Not that one.
No?
For me, okay. That's better than Time to Run. And what was the other one we put in there?
Hang on. What about It Needs to Be the Right Moment? Because like sometimes you listen to it, but sometimes you'll skip it, kind of. I'm not saying
we got a section for that.
Where? Oh, this one.
It's good.
So what should this one be? It should be something like, you don't always skip it, but like, you might do. What about like...
Well then surely that should be in When the Moment's Good, because it's like, you play it when the moment's good.
Oh, is that what In the Moment's Good means?
I'd say so.
I thought that meant like, it's decent, but then there's like a really good moment that really gets you.
Oh, no. I meant like when the moment was right to listen to it.
Oh, but I feel like that should be underneath here then.
Really?
That category. Because this is like, this one suggests like, you wouldn't ever pick it, but whenever it comes on, you would never skip it. Was that for me now suggests like, you would only listen to it when it's right, which is not all the time.
Okay, sure.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay, so what are we going to change that one to?
Oh man, this is tough, isn't it?
It is.
What are you thinking? I agree with like the levels. I just think we need to rename them slightly to be a let.
Okay.
Because I feel like otherwise we're never going to put it any below. Wouldn't skip. You know what I mean?
Hmm.
What are you thinking? Well, we can keep the name, but just change what it means a little bit. If you want. Or not.
When the beat drops.
Okay, when the beat drops. See, that's what I kind of implied for me.
That means when it gets to like a good moment.
That's what I was kind of doing it as already. So I like that. Then what could this one be? Needs to be right moment still?
Yeah, I'd say keep it on the right moment.
Okay. So for me, I would put this one here. Where would you put it?
Like, we need to go through the other ones again.
Yeah, do you feel? Oh, would you change it now?
Possibly.
Oh, okay. So we got Time to Run. Would you keep these two here, yeah? Because they haven't changed. This doesn't change. Or are you thinking proper change it?
See, this is the thing. I think it's bizarre because I think Ghost on the Shore is better than Time to Run.
Yeah.
But Ghost on the Shore I'd only listen to when the moment's right.
See, I kind of agree. I kind of agree. Damn, this is going to be a tough tier list, isn't it?
Maybe we get rid of just the tier of when the moment's right.
Completely.
Yeah, we just have five.
What, so it goes from wouldn't skip to wouldn't miss?
Yeah.
No, I don't know, though. I don't know, because I think they're sent too top heavy, because then you only have one actual bad one. Yeah. I think maybe we should change this bit, but I don't think we should get rid of... I think we're going to get rid of one. We have to get rid of one of these two.
Okay.
Or is this even, it goes from you wouldn't skip it to I don't like it, you know?
Okay.
How about, like, this one is just, like, impartial, maybe? Or, like... Sure.
Or well, like, that's what wouldn't skip, wouldn't miss is, right?
Yeah, I guess so. I guess for me, wouldn't skip, wouldn't pick is, like, you like it, it's just you would never actually put it on.
Okay.
Whereas impartial is just, like, you don't like it, but you just don't, you don't dislike it.
Okay.
Do you get what I'm saying? Do you get the, like, difference?
Yeah, no, I get what you're saying.
Like, this is, like, it's still, like, Time to Run, I really like. I would just never be like, oh, best spot on Time to Run.
Mm-hmm.
If it popped on, I wouldn't be like, oh, I'd skip this. Or what about, this one could just be, like, sometimes skip, maybe.
Okay.
Maybe.
But, yeah, but, yeah.
Like, skippable.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because skippable could be, like, one that you would sometimes skip, but wouldn't miss is, like, you would be happy to never, ever hear it again.
Yeah.
I think that's quite a good difference.
But then I feel like there should be another one above wouldn't skip, wouldn't miss. Because, like I said, Ghost on the Shore for me is better than Time to Run, but obviously it's for, like, in the moment, not...
No, I got what you're saying. Okay, so if you were just right now... Well, not right...
Okay, what about... would personally choose? Or would choose?
Oh, for this one?
Yeah.
Oh, I like that. I like that, because then it's like one you would intentionally put on.
So we got skippable, choosable, wouldn't skip, wouldn't, you know, wouldn't pick, wouldn't...
Yeah, okay, I like that. How do you spell choosable?
Or choosable or pickable? I don't know. One of them.
How do you spell choosable?
I have no idea. I didn't even know if that's a word.
It is now. Choosable. Okay, I like this though. I like this. This is a little bit more less gray area now.
Okay.
So now we have I will be back one day. For me, that's skippable.
It's skippable. Wait, no. I wouldn't pick, but I wouldn't skip.
Okay, we'll put it there. Oh, I don't know though. Because it's like
I'll let you have skippable.
Okay, I'm only saying that because I don't want it to be, like, too top-heavy.
No, I know. Yeah.
The Man Who Lives Forever.
Can you skip halfway through?
Yeah. Okay, what are you thinking?
I wouldn't miss it.
I would actually say the same. I would say the same as well.
Okay.
Nice. Okay. Lullaby. Do you remember what Lullaby is like?
Barely.
What do you think?
I wouldn't miss it.
I wouldn't miss it either. Okay. In the Wind. Oh, wait. No, it's not. It's Brother. Ooh. Okay.
Brother is... Wouldn't pick, wouldn't skip.
Yeah, wouldn't skip, wouldn't miss. Wouldn't pick, wouldn't skip.
I don't know if you'd say
the same. No, I would say the same. I would agree with you so far. I would say the same.
Okay.
I that's pretty spot on for me. Okay, now we have In the Wind. Wait. Oh, wait, where's the words? I skipped the words. What are you thinking?
I say choosable.
Oh, yes! Oh, my goodness! Oh, thank goodness. I was so scared you were going to get rid of it, man. Like, for me, I would put it, like, one of these two, but I'll allow it to be here, because I appreciate that's just me.
Okay.
But I'm just happy you didn't hate it. I really don't. That's one of my favorites, personally. So next, we have Setting Sun.
But I'm sick of it.
Pardon?
But Pete, till I'm sick of it.
I mean, right now I've gone a little bit off of it. Okay. But there was a phase where I repeated it a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I would maybe put it like here now, but I'll agree with it there because it earned its spot there, you know.
Okay.
Okay. Son of a Gun.
Yeah, he's good.
Pardon?
Are these their singles?
No, this is an Lonesome Dream album.
No way.
On Spotify it is. I don't know. I've just gone on, this isn't like my personal album. I've just gone on to the actual artist and gone on Lonesome Dreams.
Oh damn. Okay. Well, I've never heard of it.
I would say skippable.
It sounds skippable.
I mean, well, have you heard of When Will I See You Again?
Is that also Lonesome Dreams?
Yeah.
I've never heard of that.
I think they might be extras, maybe.
Either that, or I think they're the singles, you know, the ones that we, like, saw.
No, they're definitely... I know what you said, because this one's the same art, is it?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's why you... Yeah, yeah. But, no, this is in the official album that they've done.
Oh.
Like, that's what they've put this in their album on, Wait.
What?
Wait.
What?
Remember how, remember I told you about Mighty?
Yeah.
The one that is got the art for this one?
Yeah.
And you know how I said it wasn't on Spotify?
Is it on Spotify?
Yeah, like a week ago they put it on Spotify.
Oh, damn.
Yeah. Damn, I got kind of excited though, because there was one from 2020.
Yeah.
And I was like, damn, 2020? Yeah. But, I would put this one skippable as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's a reason it wasn't on the original album.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's Lonesome Dreams done. Is there any you would switch around? Any you don't? I think we've done pretty well.
I think that's decent.
I think that's very decent. This is now where we turn on each other.
Oh, yes.
I didn't have like a personal attachment to those ones. The next line here, Strange Trails, is gonna be spicy.
I'm ready.
So starting off strong with Love Like Ghosts. Do 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 do. What are you saying?
Skip halfway through.
It does. Oh yeah, I think it does get a bit faster. Get ready for the O's, ready?
I say choosable.
Hold on. What are you saying?
I say choosable.
I was going to say repeat till I'm sick of it.
It doesn't sound like a song I'd repeat, you know?
Oh, but it's so gas, though. It's the one that's the same beat as Meet Me in the Woods.
No, I know. And that was the one I was saving. Meet Me in the Woods is Grab the Orcs.
Don't spoil.
Well, now you brought it up now, so that's where it was going to go. For me. But we'll talk about that later. I think that Meaning in the Woods is a lot faster, which is why I'd repeat it. Whereas, because this is a more slow song, it's more of one I choose in a moment.
I don't know. For me, it's more of an choosable. It's more of an choosable.
Yeah. I'll let you choose. I'll let you decide.
Okay. I owe you one.
Okay.
I owe you one. That's going to come back to bite me, you know.
Yes, it is, because...
You're going to do the Marmite technique on me.
Uh-huh.
All right, we have Until the Night Turns. What are you thinking?
I say choosable.
I say it's choosable. I say it's very choosable. I will say that is the definition, even though we're not putting it there, it's the definition of wouldn't pick but wouldn't skip. Because it comes on and you've not picked it, but as soon as it comes on, you're like, you get hyped.
Put it there then.
Maybe.
I'll put it there.
Because for me, it's always the one that, like, I never put it on intentionally, but as soon as it comes on, you start, like, jiving to it, you know?
Yeah.
I would say so. Okay, Dead Man's Hand.
I wouldn't pick, but I wouldn't skip. Skippable.
Yeah, me too. Like, when you're in the right mood, I think for all of these, if you're in the right mood, you know, you can listen
to it. That's what I tell everyone. Like, whenever I tell anyone to watch it or listen to it, and they listen to it, and it's like, it's not really my song. But I was like, but did you listen when you were in the right mood, though?
Yeah, it's so true.
Because, like, if you did, then you're going to hate it.
Yeah, no, 100%. Like, it's the kind of thing where, like, We've joked about it a lot, where I'd be like, oh, Elliot, check out this one. And you check it, you're like, eh. And then, like, 2 hours later, you're like, damn, that's a good song.
Yeah.
But because you listen to it in a different scenario.
No, exactly.
But, like, none of these songs are bad, you know?
No. Well, debatable. We'll get there.
These two are arguably, like, I wouldn't actually miss them. But everything above wouldn't miss, I like.
Okay.
Okay, Hurricane. What are you thinking?
I wouldn't pick, but I wouldn't skip.
I'm with you 100%. It's very similar to that one. To me, is very similar to Until the Night Turns.
Yeah.
Okay, the next one is a very interesting choice, because this one I think is very underrated.
Okay.
Which one it is?
No.
It's La Belle Fleur Sauvage.
Play it.
Hold on. Hold on, wait. No, this isn't justifying it. Hold on.
What do you mean? That does justify it.
What would you say?
Either choosable or repeat.
Oh, good. Okay, I thought... Okay, good. I didn't think you liked it. Okay, good. Pardon?
I didn't, but...
But you like it now?
Yeah. But I've liked it for a while. But, like, when I told you I didn't like it, I didn't like it.
Oh, good. Okay, good. I thought you were going to skip it. Okay, which one do you want now? I'm happy either.
I'd say choosable.
Okay. But I think it's just a very peaceful song, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I really like it. Okay. Fall for Love. Ooh. Pardon?
Now I've heard it. Repeat.
Yeah, I'm saying repeat, dude. That's a good... That was, like, their first big song, I think.
Really?
Yeah, that got into, like, the actual charts and stuff.
Oh, damn, okay.
Yeah, I think it might have been in a movie, maybe. But, yeah, that's it's a decent song. Okay, The World Ender.
You got to keep going. Because, like, look how many songs they got that never made it into the charts before that one.
Exactly, yeah. No, it's
like, actually decent.
Yeah, like, they deserve to be, but it doesn't surprise me that they're not, you know?
No.
Because it's a very particular, like... kind of music.
Mm.
But I do, yeah, I think, out of all of them so far, which one do you think could be, like, in the charts? Like, which one do you think people would like it? Because I would say, with a lot of them, it's like, people would like it if they got to hear it. But yeah. They just about it, you know?
That's, yeah, I think that is the reason for all of them.
I would say, probably, I know we haven't got to yet, Meet Me in the Woods is, I would say, that's, like, a good way to get people into it.
That one's underrated.
Oh, for sure. I love
it. Might even... Okay, no, we'll get there. We'll get there. We'll get there.
Okay. The World Ender. What do you think?
Choosable.
I think it's very choosable. I like it. I like that one. And they did a little comic about it as well, didn't they?
Yeah.
I like that one. Okay, the next one. Do we need to listen? Do we need to?
Yeah, just because I want to.
Do. Let's get. What are you thinking?
It's their best song.
It's, for me, like, my favourite songs always go in and out, but there's a few songs which are always just, they're always in the conversation.
This is it.
And this is always, it's always in my top five, you know?
100%.
Or, like, even if I don't put it there, I'm always like, okay, it probably should be there. Like, it's just so, like, the thing I love about that is I remember when I first told you about them, and that was one of your first go-tos. Like, it's always been that one of your top ones, I think, hasn't it?
Oh, sure.
Yeah. I think, for me, there's sometimes where you're not bored of it, but sometimes you move on to a different artist or whatever, you know, to get, like, a bit of a different take on music. Mm-hmm. Whenever you get that song, you're like, okay, I need to listen to some more Lil Horan again.
Uh-huh.
It always gets you right into it, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. It
gets you right into Lil Horan. I do love Meet Me in the Woods.
It deserves to be top tier.
It does. It really, really does. It really does. Okay. The Yawning Grave. Ta-da-da. I speak to birds until the night flies. Hold on, there's a really good bit. Hold on.
Just because of that bit, it's choosable.
Yeah, it really is. That's like the best bit, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
Because it goes from really, like, chill and it gets, like, proper into it that bit. I really like that bit.
Yeah.
Okay. The next... Okay, we're getting... we're getting to some that I actually really love now. I'm scared. I'm actually scared.
Frozen Plains, isn't it?
Dude, Frozen... okay, wait, let me play a bit first. Do-do-do-do-do. Wait for it. Pardon?
It's top tier.
Yes! Oh, wait, are you actually saying that?
Yeah.
Yes! Let's go, dude.
100%.
Oh, pardon?
I don't think it's as good as Meet Me in the Woods, but man, no. It is close.
My favourite bit, ready? I'll play my favourite bit. I don't know why, I just always get hyped for it. Ready? It's like in the movie, it's like the best bit, ready? Get ready. Hold on. Oh, wait.
The thing is, you can hear the build-up.
Yeah, here it comes. Wait, hold on, no, it's not. Okay, I found it. Okay, ready? Here we go.
Yeah.
Get ready. Do-do-do-do-do-do.
Oh, I know. Dude. I remember when we actually went to that casting thing in Salisbury, when you showed me the song for the first time.
Yeah, I remember that as well. When I was like, I told you about the like UFO stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I remember. I remember. Yeah, that was good. That was good.
It's for sure one of the, it's top tier.
Similar to Meet Me in the Woods, whenever I hear that, it always makes me want to listen to Lord Huron like that whole day. Yeah. It really does. It really, really does.
It's yeah, quite a few songs that I'll listen to and make me want to like do that. Like
yeah, definitely.
Frozen Plans and Meet Me in the Woods will 100% do that. Other ones that will do that maybe are like Ghosts on the Shore, Lonesome Dreams, Ends of the Earth. At least for me.
Yeah, for me, In the Wind does it. That's because it's a personal favorite.
Okay.
But I don't know, because that's a little bit more slower. But these two are just like, they just get you.
Yeah.
Okay, Cursed.
I remember this one now.
No, me neither completely.
You just that ending of that line. Just the ending of that line just kind of adds to it so much.
It really does, doesn't it? I'll skip a bit into what happens. Whoa.
Just that. Like, for me, that's choosable.
Oh, wait, dude, there's a bit I forgot about. Like, I just paused it already. The rest of the bit you hear is like, it gets you a bit more excited. Get ready.
Oh, for sure.
It does get you a bit, doesn't it? It's choosable. Choosable.
It's choosable.
Okay, Way Out There, for me, is one of my favorites.
Let's see.
Yeah, okay, good. Like, that was my original favorite, I would say.
It's close top tier.
It's very close top tier. Okay, I'm going to play you a bit, and I think you might change. Because there's... hang on, let me play it first, and then I'll talk. Think. Yes, dude.
Man, I thought too.
The bit that I love, hold on, is that the instrument.
Yeah, theremin.
What's it called again?
Theremin.
Yeah, yeah. Oh man, every time I hear it, I always want to try. But yeah, oh man, Way Out There. I remember I listened to it before I went traveling. And it always got me hyped because it talks about, like, traveling and stuff a little bit.
That's the point. That's why I love them so much.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. Dude. Oh, man. That one has a special place in my heart. Like, I think it's one that, like, when everyone ever talks about best, I always forget about it in a little bit. You know, you always kind of discard it. But as soon as you hear it again, you're like, okay, this is actually kind of good.
Yeah.
For sure. Okay, next one. Do we need to... it's top tier, right?
Play it. Oh, nah, get that wouldn't miss.
Dude, come on.
You said you owe me one.
Get ready for the best bit. Rest of my days.
It's choosable.
Pardon?
Choosable.
I'll accept choosable.
Really dislike the whole Louisa bit.
What do you mean when he just says Louisa?
Yeah.
See, I would agree with that. But the actual
the rest of it is decent.
Yeah, it really is. Like, I remember when I will say when I first started listening to them, I didn't like it for the same reason, where you just hear, like, Louisa.
Yeah.
But when you get, like, into it a little bit, and, like, if you were forced to, for some reason, listen to it, like, on repeat for an hour, I think afterwards you'd be like, actually, that's a kind of good song.
Yeah.
So that's why I'm happy putting it in Choosable, for sure.
Right. Okay.
The next one, I feel like we have to put it in Grab the Orcs. Let me play it, but I think, you know, it's like the song, isn't it?
It is, but I'd say Chooseable. I wouldn't, like... but then if I did listen to it, I would be like, damn, Lord Huron.
Let me play it. Oh, come on! That, ooh!
Yeah, no, just put it in there. Just put it in.
As soon as you hear the all, you know. I will say, it's not necessarily a better song, but it's like, you know, it's like Coca-Cola. It just has to be there, you know?
Yeah.
It's just the song, isn't it?
Mm.
I will play a little bit more, though, just because. I will say, I do love the little, like, oohs.
Yeah.
The funny thing is, I kind of forget sometimes that I found Lord Huron from 13 Reasons Why.
See, I didn't.
What do you mean?
I found them. Wait, Ends of the Earth was my first song. I know, because I found them while watching that Walking with Dinosaurs movie.
Oh, yeah, no, I saw that was in there. Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Like, look at Ends of the Earth. Look at that picture. That is the exact scene where the dinosaur walking on top of the sand dunes that night.
Oh, yeah, no, I have to, yeah, I know exactly what you're on about, yeah.
Like, and I'm like, damn, like, now that I think about it, they just copied the art.
Oh, really? yeah, for sure.
But it definitely got popular for 13 Reasons. I feel like that's where most of their fans came from.
Yeah, it does. And it's annoying because, like, I am one of those fans, but at the same time, I'm like...
You listen to the rest.
Yeah, exactly.
I feel like a lot of people that came from 13 Reasons kind of just listened to that and maybe a couple of others and then that's it.
Yeah, for sure. I will say, there's a lot of, with basically every Lord Huron song, the lyrics are just so well written.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it shows with Nigel Matt.
That's the thing. Lord Huron, one of the only bands I will listen to the lyrics.
Yeah, for sure. Like, and there's times where I listen to a song like 100 times and I listen to it again and I'll be like, wait, I didn't even realize they said that, you know?
No, yeah, I know that. Yeah.
It's such a good feeling when you notice something you've never noticed before.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's just so good. I really, really like them. Like,
yeah.
Dude, like, I forget sometimes as well, but I've actually seen them live.
Lucky.
I know. Like, if they're ever in Bristol again, no matter what situation it is, we have to go and see it.
Oh, for sure.
Because I promise you right now, because, like, for example, let me think of one. The World Ender, before I saw him live, I was like, eh. And also, like, Fall for Love. And I saw him live, and there's something about hearing it live, you're like, damn, I kind of like it now.
Okay.
Yeah, when you see him live, like, Louise is going to shoot out of that, you know.
Okay.
The next one is one that's not on an album, but it's a very good song for me. So I've included it anyway, because it's, like, the only one. I didn't want to just leave one out, you know.
Okay.
But it's The Birds Are Singing at Night. Wait, have you heard this one before?
You've played it for me a little bit, I think.
Okay. Hold on. Let me get to the proper chorus. Okay, ready? Get ready, Elliot, get ready. Hold on. Here it comes, Elliot.
I'm ready. Repeat till I'm sick.
Dude, I really like that song. I really like it.
Mm-hmm.
So, is that the first time you probably heard the chorus then?
Probably, yeah.
It's good. Like, you know what is funny? I kind of forget sometimes that Lord Huron is, like, all sung by the same guy.
Yeah.
Because they're all so different, aren't they?
Do you say Mighty is a good one?
Mighty?
Yeah.
Well, I've not really heard it properly, to be honest.
Oh, okay. Because I just looked on the Android App Store.
Yeah.
They put it up, and they put it up this month.
Yeah, yeah. I've not really heard it properly, to be honest with you. I've not really heard it, but a lot of people like it. A lot of people like it. There's also one that we haven't got here, but it's called We Went Wild. Have you heard of that one?
Maybe.
A lot of people like that one. A lot of people like We Went Wild.
Yeah.
But I've never really gave it a chance because it's just I've only really listened to ones on the actual albums like officially.
Yeah.
But yeah, the Birds Thing at Night is one of my favorites. But okay. Wait, it gives me hope because they released that like not on an album, so I'm hoping they just release
it's
like
part of, it's for a movie.
It was for a movie.
I'm looking at it now. I just bought it.
Did you actually? Damn. Did you get a little bit hooked on it then?
A little bit actually. Yeah.
The reason I like it, and you hear if you listen to it a couple times, you hear it. The first chorus, it has like one bit, and then the second chorus, the second time they do, it's like doubled length, and it just gets you gassed the second time. Because it's just like you expect it to stop, and it just keeps going. Oh, you're here. I think that might be one of your. Yeah.
What's the Stranger?
The Stranger is also a popular one actually.
Yeah, because I just looked up We Went Wild, and then it's part of,
Yeah, like a little packet.
With Time to Run and The Man Who Lives Forever.
Do you want me to play you a bit of The Stranger?
It sounds good, to be fair.
Yeah, it's actually not bad.
Damn. We Went Wild, this just sounds good, you know.
What, The Stranger?
No, We Went Wild.
Oh, We Went Wild is actually kind of a banger, low-key.
I just bought them.
Did you actually? You know what, to be fair, I feel like We Went Wild deserves more credit, because it's actually good, isn't it?
Mm.
How much of it did you listen to?
A decent amount.
Did you listen to the ending? Like no. The end of it, towards the end. It gets like proper fast.
Okay.
Hold on. Yeah, I think definitely gives We Went Wild a few listens later on because it's quite good.
Okay.
But we've moved on to the final album, which I'm very nervous for this. I'm the most nervous for this one. But first of all, we have Lost in Time and Space.
I'd say choosable.
I would as well, actually. I'm not gonna lie, before I played that, I was expecting like a skippable. And now I've listened to it, I'm like, man, that's actually better than I remember.
Yeah.
I like it. Okay, next one is called Never Ever.
Oh, now, dude, I think that's the one that I played around yours and I was like...
Yeah, oh. I was about to say that. It definitely is. I'm going to play
Grab the end. The Orcs.
Pardon?
Grab the Orcs.
Well, let me play it first, but I'm pretty sure you might have to put it on there. Because it starts off like this, and this is what I think you remember.
Yeah, because I thought it was like going to be like an indie thing.
You heard the ending? You heard the ending, and you were like, damn, that's good, buddy. That's kind of a banger, you know.
Let's grab the Yorks, man.
Let's do it. Dude, I'm down.
Not for the fact that it would remind me of Lord Huron, just for the fact that it's a good song.
It is kind of actually a really good song.
Yeah.
And like, oh, I do like it. It's a good, it's very good.
Mm-hmm.
It's very, very good. They actually performed that on the James Corden show.
Did they actually?
Yeah, they performed it on the James Corden show.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, and I can see, because obviously they had to perform one from their new album. I can see why they chose that one.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, I can definitely see that. Okay, Ancient Names Part 1 and 2. Do you remember the differences?
One is slow, one is fast.
So this is number one. So it starts off like this. And then later on, it's like this. And then a bit later on, it's like this. Oh, hold on, not that. That's the trigger.
That's a repeat that I'm sick of it.
Me too. I'm very much in agreement with that one. I like that one.
I think it was part two that I didn't like so much.
Yeah, I'm with part two of this.
Yeah, that's like, I wouldn't pick it, but I wouldn't skip it.
Yeah, me too. I kind of agree. Like, it's definitely not anywhere near the part one.
No.
Alright, what's the next one? Oh! Ooh! This might be our first proper disagreement, the next one.
What is it?
You're about to hear it.
Dude, that's crappy.
Wait, really?
Yeah.
Dude, I thought you hated that one.
Yeah, I mean, it's one of the best songs now. I don't know what you're all about.
Dude, I love Wait by the River. I love it. It's so good. I don't know. Maybe someone else hates it. I was convinced you were going to say this one down
I'm
here.
Pretty sure I hated it at some point, but man, I love it now. Like, dude, it's one of the best songs.
And you know what I appreciate? I appreciate they went really different to what they've done before.
Yeah.
Like, it's so different. It's just so good. Yeah.
But it's not like Ghosts on a Shore slow. It's slower.
Yeah, but it works. It works.
Mm-hmm.
Wait by the river.
That's so good.
It is actually legitimately really good. Oh, this one's a nice place. All right. So next... Dude, I can't believe I thought we were going to disagree so much more.
Oh, so
okay, the next one, I'm hoping you're going to say the same.
Glad that was...
Pardon?
Grab that Orcs.
Grab that Orcs. Secret Life is a low-key, like, maybe one of my favorites.
It really is.
Like, I just love it. Lives ago.
Okay.
Get ready. Hold on.
That's bad.
That is a certified grab the Orcs. I like that song a lot.
Yeah, 100%.
Man, see now I'm like now I've listened to it. I'm like I really can't tell which one's my favorite album.
No,
because like, oh man, they're just so good.
I mean, I'm just saying we didn't put any Lonesome Dreams ones in Grab the Orcs.
Yeah, we might have to reconsider maybe, I think.
But for me, Lonesome Dreams has the better amount of songs.
Okay, I can see what you mean by that. I think
Strange Trails number one.
Yeah.
Lonesome Dreams two. Vide Noir three. It's close.
I can see why you say that. Yeah, there's no album I dislike at all.
No.
I think Strange Trials, most people will universally say Strange Trials, I think.
Mm-hmm.
It's just so consistent. It's just so, like, insanely good.
Yeah.
Me, I think the reason I like Vide Noir is because it's obviously, I was a fan of when it came out, so it was, like, my first proper... From any musician, like waiting for an album to come out and then it got released, you know?
Okay.
It was like my first proper musician I was into, and then they released their first album. It would be like, I imagine for you, when they release their next album, it'd be like that for you, you know?
Oh, probably.
Because you'll be like, damn, there's new songs on Low Tire. And then you listen to them, and then it's just a really strange experience when you get to listen to a new album of Low Tire. So I think for me, that's why it's like a special spot in my heart.
Okay.
But Lonesome Dreams is like, even Lonesome Dreams is just amazing.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. The next one, though. is Back from the Edge. Okay, that goes like that. Okay. What are you thinking?
I was going to say I wouldn't miss it, but you know, I it's either I wouldn't skip or wouldn't pick or skippable.
I think, yeah, I'm kind of with you. Let's say skippable, just so it's a little bit less biased, maybe.
Okay.
But it's not. It's better than what I remembered because I was expecting I wouldn't miss it as well. Then.
Yeah.
The next one. Okay, the next one. Oh, what? Oh, maybe it's another. Okay, next one is Bounce to Die.
Keep it going. We haven't got to the best bit yet.
Okay. Which is the best bit? Oh, I forgot. Is it after this?
No. But that is a good bit. That's a good bit. That is like probably better, but it's a different bit. It's more earlier in the song, I think.
Which is it when it gets fast, or are you on about something else?
No, I'm on about something else. This bit. Right.
Ooh. Oh, I know which bit.
That was a good bit. Again. But it's the bit when he's like, is it when he says everyone's a sinner and the balance is I?
Oh, hold on. Let me find it. Hold on. I'm going to find it for you because that is a good bit. Hold on a second. I'm going to be...
It's the first words he says.
Oh. Okay, ready? Here we go. Okay, hold on. It's going into it. Here we go.
Because you listen to this and you're like, meh.
Pardon?
You listen to this and you're like, meh.
Oh, yeah, like if you missed the specific bit. Yeah, yeah. It's good, you know. Oh, man.
Hold on.
Yeah.
I don't know what bit it is then. I swear there's a bit. Maybe it's in a different song. I don't know. I swear there's...
Here we go, Elliot.
That's the line. I'm tempted to put it in Oaks, but I think it's repeat.
Yeah, I think repeat as well, but it's borderline. It's definitely borderline. Uh-huh. But yeah, that line on its own, just everyone's a sinner and a balance of life. When you actually think about it, You're like, damn.
It's not even that. It's that the music really cuts off when he says it.
Yeah, it really does.
It's like, all you can focus on is the lyrics.
Yeah.
And dude, ah.
That's something they're really good at doing there, aren't they?
Mm-hmm.
They're really good at going from, like, really into, like, music to, like, okay, lyric time, you know?
Yeah.
And that's what gets you gassed when it goes from being, like, slow.
We're going to call that as a new saying in the music industry. All right, lyric time.
Lyric time. Lyric time. Ariana Grande doesn't have enough lyric time. Okay, the next one. We got four left. Here we go.
That's repeat.
Pardon?
It's repeat.
It is. Do you like it?
I do.
Good.
I like it a lot.
I like it a lot. For me, it's potentially Grab the Yorks.
Same. It's, for me, that's like the runner-up for Wait by the River.
Yeah, okay, yeah, I kind of see that. I kind of see that a little bit.
Mm.
Where are you putting it?
I'd say repeat. But if you think Orcs, then...
I'm very tempted to say Orcs. No, you know what? Let's go, we'll go repeat. Because I like it as much as When the Birds Are Singing at Night.
Okay.
Okay. But there's one bit I do want to play. Let me try and find it a second. Because there's a bit I really like, and it'll come back in later in a minute as well.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on. Oh, okay, hold on. Hold on a second.
Okay.
Okay, I got it. Okay, it's about to be in a minute, ready? I'm bringing it up for a reason as well, which I'll say it in a minute. Hang on. Okay, there's two reasons I love that moment.
Mm-hmm.
Apart from the actual like beat change and stuff, I love how he says about hearing the river say his name. It's because in the story, he's like currently waiting by the river.
Mm-hmm.
But also the other bit that I'll say now and I'll bring up in a minute is when he says about by the stars above, I know we were in love. Okay, Do you know why I said that?
Is it because of the fortune teller?
Not quite. Okay, there's a line in another song in a minute which kind of like goes with that.
Okay.
Because obviously in the story so far, without giving it away to like, but I was, not to you, but giving away to anyone else. Obviously he's like looking for his loved one.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, oh, I knew we were in love. Blah blah blah. Okay, so I'll bring it up in a minute. I'll bring it up in a minute because it's like it's kind of sad. But the next one we have is Moonbeam.
This is an interesting one. I don't remember liking it that much, but I remember also getting to like it, and I don't know where I stand on it right now. So,
if I'm honest, I'm actually in the same boat as you. I remember being like, oh, actually, it's not as bad as I thought it was.
No.
I think it's because it starts off kind of air, I mean, later on it's good. We'll listen. Okay, I'll skip to the chorus. Okay. Well, I remember liking this bit.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I say skippable.
I would say skippable. Like, I could, like, if I was feeling it, I could put it a bit higher.
Yeah.
But I think it's skippable based on the intro.
Mm-hmm.
But there's parts of it I'm like, oh, that's kind of groovy. But I
that's
think
it. There are parts, right?
It's yeah, like... exactly, exactly. And unless you're into it, you'll skip it.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. But, okay, two more, here we go. Dun, 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 dun.
Last one's Beard Noir, right? Which one's this one?
This is Beard Noir.
What's the last one?
Emerald Star.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. To be fair, I'll play obviously a bit more, but the intro is kind of catchy, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It gets you, like, grooving a bit.
Yeah.
Have you got any? I can't remember what else happens in this song.
Choosable.
Oh, actually, yeah, there's a good bit ready. There's a good bit I forgot about.
Okay.
Get ready. What are you thinking?
Choosable.
I think Choosable is a solid pick. I think it's fair. Okay. Lastly but not least, we have this, which I have a title of this. Emerald Star.
No, but that was for the album, not the song.
Yeah, it was more of a symbolizer of the artist. But technically, I have the Emerald Star on me. For life.
This wouldn't miss it.
No. I do say, like, I kind of like the intro. Cool. Elliot, get ready for that thing I told you to remember. Ready? Here we go. What are you thinking?
I wouldn't pick it, but I would skip it.
I would say repeat till I'm sick of it.
Really?
I actually have done. Like, I genuinely love this song. Look, I will admit you have to be in the right mood. But it's
choosable?
I think maybe choosable then, because I really love this song.
Okay.
Like, did you know, like, I love how, like, 4 songs ago he was like, by the stars above, I know we were in love. And then literally like 4 songs later, after he actually finds the Emerald Star, he's like, no, you never loved me. Yeah, I love that. It's kind of sad a little bit, actually.
But that's the story, isn't it? It's like she leaves him.
She leaves him.
Because of a fight.
And then the story is like him trying to find her, basically.
Yeah, and he goes to like
a fortune teller.
Fortune teller, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does, yeah. And then he finds out he only has like a day to live.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a bit of like, ooh, because it's like, he finds out that, like, by the morning, he's going to be dead.
Yeah.
And then obviously he goes to find her. He finds out that she's been taking the Vide Noir, which is like a drug.
Yeah.
And then he decides to kill himself because he realizes she doesn't love him.
Oh, wait, Vide Noir is a drug.
Yeah, Vide Noir is a drug.
Oh, damn. Okay. Mm.
But the reason it's kind of like sad is because he goes after her thinking he's only got a day left.
Yeah.
But finding her and realizing she doesn't love him is what kills him, you know? That's why he dies, because he commits suicide.
Oh.
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, I know, damn. It's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Because then it's like, it was like a self-fulfilling prophecy, really.
Yeah.
Mm. I mean, there's lines in between. I think there's a line in, like, Wait Bell River at some point, where he says about, like, he says something about a noose at some point.
Okay.
So it's, like, hinting towards it. But, yeah. I think it's decent. And I like how he says about different bits. Like, he's like, in that one there, he's about, like, loss in time and space, which is actually, like, a callback to the first one.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's good. I think we've done very well there, actually.
We didn't disagree as much as I thought we would.
Not really, no. We actually didn't. I think that's because I remember you disliking a few that I thought you disliked.
Ah, okay.
So I was expecting you to hate Wait by the River and maybe Never Ever.
Mm-hmm.
And also and In the Wind. So I was like ready to like actually proper fight you. Then as soon as you were like, oh no, I like that, I was like, oh okay. No, I'm quite impressed.
We did well.
We really did. And this is the thing, like even these movies, even these songs are still decent, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Like these aren't necessarily bad songs.
But that's the thing, right? If you look at all the ones above Skippable, there's almost triple the amount.
Exactly. You know? Oh, yeah, exactly. Yeah, for sure.
So.
Like, I feel like if you did this with any other artist, there would be a lot of Skippables.
Yeah.
But maybe that's just me being biased, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah.
But, I'm really happy. I can't wait for... We'll have to review the movie.
Okay, next up, we get a guest.
Yeah.
To do Ariana Grande.
A guest.
Yeah.
That would be... I feel like we would offend some people. Like, I feel like, if we weren't huge fans of Lautaro, you know, we would have rated a few years lower. And I feel like because we're not huge fans of Ariana Grande, well, we're, you know, I like a good Ariana Grande song now and again. But,
yeah,
you know, we'll be like, oh, that was trash. And whoever it was would be like, what do you mean? That's my favorite song. Because to be fair, even with the ones we disagreed on, we could kind of reason with the other person and be like, you know what? I can see what your point is.
Yeah. You know,
like with Emerald Star, you're like, okay, that's fair enough.
Oh, yeah, no, for sure.
So, yeah, I'm really impressed. I'm happy we did that. Any final Lord Haran comments?
We need to increase our quota on how many friends we have who listen to this song, listen to these songs.
We actually do. I don't know who we can get in, though.
Like, we either find more friends that like this, or we just convert friends already.
Okay, that's true. Who could we create? Oh, maybe Hugo, I think.
I don't know.
I could see Hugo being persuaded.
Really?
Maybe. Who would you say?
I really don't know. I don't think I know anybody who would.
I mean, the actual truth is, we just convinced everyone who was watching.
Oh, for sure.
Like,
if you haven't listened to them yet, go listen to them.
That's the thing. Imagine if like someone actually watches this, and because of it, they'd give it a listen, you know?
What channel is this going on?
It's up to you. What would you want it on?
Post-credits. I'd say put them on post-credits.
Yeah.
At least maybe the movie ones. Maybe the song one as well.
Pardon?
Or maybe this one as well.
Okay, I would be down. I would be down for sure.
Because I feel like on post-credits, when the new album comes out, we should review it. As well as the movie.
Yeah, we definitely need to.
So, like, I think we should do a first-time listening.
Oh, that would be insane.
I think that'd be good.
That would be really good.
Do, like, a 1 week later and what we think of it.
Damn, okay, I'm down. I'm definitely down for that.
Let's do it.
Damn, I would be scared to do that, though. I'd be scared.
Why?
I don't know. I feel like we'd end up like not being as satisfied as we would want to.
What do you mean?
Because a few Lord Horn songs, you know, you need a few listens before you get to really, like, get
no,
to it.
That would be the point of the first listen, right?
Okay, I get... No, okay, I get you. I get you. I get you.
So we'll see. We'll see.
Okay, we'll see. But yeah, that has been it for our tier list. We hope you've enjoyed. The main thing to take away from this is if you've never heard or listened to them, go and listen to them now.
Yes.
Hopefully I was able to... hopefully we're by playing out the snippets, you were able to get convinced to listen in.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we really want. That's what we really want here.
All I can say is, despite the intro, give the rest a chance.
Yeah, I definitely, if you're going to do anything, listen past the intros.
Yeah.
And if you're really unsure, listen to me, Meet Me By Words, and then you're in.
Because I'm terrible with to do that with songs. Like, I'll listen to the first, like, 5 seconds of the intro, and if I don't like it, I won't listen.
Oh, yeah, me too, for sure.
So.
No, I did that with, like literally every Lord Horn song.
Yeah.
I went through 4 stages. Stage one was I watched 30 Reasons Why. I really liked The Night We Met, and I listened to that on its own for, like, a whole day.
Okay.
Like, on repeat. And then I was like, okay, well, I need to listen to a few more because, like, I can't listen to one song constantly. So then I was like, I went through and I, like, just listened to the start of every Lord Horn song.
Yeah.
And I picked out Meet Me By The Words, Way Out There. And I think, maybe even Love's Like Ghost, I think. Or Fall For Love. It was 4 of those 5. I just then listened to those on repeat for, like, a week.
Yeah.
But in my mind, I was like, okay, well, I listened to all the others a little bit and they weren't great. Oh, no, it was Ends of the Earth, Ends of the Earth. It was Meet Me In The Words, Way Out There, Ends of the Earth, and The Night We Met.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, well, there must be more, because, like, this is so good. Surely there must be more. And then I listened to, like, I got a couple more in there, you know, I grabbed a few of the upper ones in, and I had, like, 8 to 10, maybe. And then, after I listened to all of them, I was like, you know what? I'm just going to put everyone in a playlist and just listen to it, even if I don't like it originally.
Damn.
So far, every single one I've actually gave a chance, I've loved. So I'm just going to have to listen to it. And I just listen. I mean, I think I even made a playlist specifically not including the ones I've already listened to.
Okay.
So that I wouldn't, like, skip to my favourites, you know?
Yeah.
And I just listened to them. And, like, after a week, I was just hooked.
No, that's fair.
Yeah, there's a little background of my Lord Horn origins. But yeah.
It was sort of similar.
Yeah.
It was like, I heard that Ends of the Earth song.
Yeah.
Heard Nightly Met.
Nice.
I can't remember if I listened to Nightly Met before 13 Reasons, because then when 13 Reasons came on, I was like, oh, I know this song.
Yeah, okay, that makes sense. That makes sense.
But I never really listened to the rest, and then it was you that listened to the rest, and you were like, damn, we're a good band. And I was like,
I was just like, oh, you need to give us a listen.
And then I did, and then I hated every single song. But then the more I listened, the more I liked them.
Yeah, for sure. It definitely does that, for sure. You know, I'm not right. Like, deep down now, I'm tempted to go and listen to some more.
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, you know what? I'm going to have to listen to some more today. But yeah, it's good. It's very good. I think that's what I hate most about lockdown, is, like, there's not as much chance to listen to songs.
No, yeah, I get that.
I always listen to songs when I, like, walk to work or I got on the bus, you know?
Yeah.
But no, I don't get that. So this was a nice little Lord Horn session.
Mm.
It was quite nice to actually get to talk about every single one.
Yeah.
That was quite a fun little thing. I enjoyed that.
Can't wait for the next album.
Pardon?
Can't wait for the next album.
Which hopefully is next year. Well, we got to wait for the movie and then the album.
When is the movie?
This year at some point.
Is it actually?
It was this year before lockdown. I don't know if it's changed. Ooh. But it's meant to be 2020.
Okay.
But they haven't said when.
I'm excited.
If it ends up being this year, that's insane. Because that's like, well, I mean, we're already halfway through it, so.
Exactly. We're so close.
It would be very exciting. Hopefully we can watch it together, because that would be really good.
I hope they release it. I know it's a movie.
Yeah.
And that takes a lot of work. But if the whole soundtrack for the movie was a new album, dude, I'm in.
That would be insane. That's something I could see him doing.
Yeah.
I guess that's like a long-term thing to be like, oh, or even like, I think definitely a new song.
Yeah.
A couple of new songs. But yeah, I guess we'll have to wait and see.
Yeah.
But to end the video, I would like to just do one thing. And as soon as I do this, video is going to end. Thank you for watching. I've been James.
Wait, do what?
You've got to say I've been Elliot.
Mate, I thought you were changing Louisa to top tier. I was going to be like,
no! No, 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 of course not. I've been James.
I've been Elliot.
Boom.
Don't you dare. Leave that back up.
Thank you for watching, guys.
Put it back.
I've been waiting to get that one.
Save it right now.
It's gonna end as soon as I dropped it in.
Save it right now.
Okay, thank you for watching, everybody. Although they're already gone, it ended as soon as the Marmite got dropped.
Ah, okay.
That's the last view. That's the last thing we're gonna see, is just to get dropped in and you'd be like, no. But no, that was a good little session.
Yes.